Hello, I am Raúl de Technology Savvy, and today I am going to talk to you about SEO, Search Engine Optimization. First, I want to tell you that I am not an SEO expert, but I do the SEO of my blog, thetechnologysavvy.com. My goal with this video is that you know the main concepts, so you can do also the SEO for your website or blog. Or if you want to hire someone else, for example in Fiverr, you want to hire an SEO expert on Fiverr, you can measure that person's work. So if you want to know the main concept of search engine optimization, stay with me because we begin right now. Okay. Let's begin with this video about Search Engine Optimization, SEO. So, what is Search Engine Optimization? What is SEO? Okay, Search Engine Optimization is all the work that you do to rank high your website or blog in the search engines. All the work that you do with the goal to rank high your website or blog. Search Engine Optimization, SEO, is a process because every step is related to one another. So it's a process. First, you do your first step in Search Engine Optimization for your website or your blog, and the other step is related to the first step. It's a process. So for me, Search Engine Optimization is a discipline because you have to do SEO every day. And trust me, Once you start doing SEO for your website or blog, you will do it every day because every day you have to check if your efforts are going to that goal to that is rank high in the search engines. Okay, let me tell you this. SEO, search engine optimization, has two parts: on page and off page. On page SEO is all the work you do on your website or blog, like picking the right keywords, optimizing the URLs, writing the correct meta description, and other optimization. In the other hand, off-page SEO has to be on promotion of your blog because your website or blog needs to have links for other blog. Like I told you before, the goal of this video is that you learn all the concepts of SEO. Okay, my friends, now let's start with the most technical part. On-page SEO, on-page search engine optimization. And for that, we have to answer another question. How do search engines work? The goal of search engine is to show you the best information for your query. And the process is crawling, indexing, and serving. Let's begin with crawling. Every search engine has robots, and like people say, crawlers or spiders. The mission of these bots is to crawl the internet looking for new or update content. The content can be text, videos, photos, PDFs, mainly everything that can be hosted on the internet. But the only way that the robots have to discover the new or update content is by links. These robots can start crawling through a few web pages, and because these web pages have links to other web pages, they start to discover new content. That's why I am showing you this graphic, because as you can see, the spider starts in one website and they discover links and go to another website or another website. So let me tell you that every search engine has its own robot. For example, Google has 17 crawling robots. Bing has 3 crawling robots. If you want to know a details every one of these, for example, Google 17 crawling robots or Bing 3 crawling robots, please go to read my post. I will let you the link in the description section down below. Right? So imagine in the graphic that you are watching, the 17 crawling robots or Google go website per website. It's amazing. It's amazing how search engines work. Now, let me talk to you about indexing. After the robots have crawled the web, the search engine index all the URLs. To give you an example, imagine the work of a librarian. The librarian has to organize the books by themes, history, science, medicine, etc. The search engine do the same work. They index all the URLs by themes. Also, you can see that I am using URL, but what URL stand for? URL stand for Uniform Resource Locator. Let me explain you in this graphic. For example, the technologysavvy.com is the domain name, but the complete URL is technologysavvy.com, how to start blog, get followers. That's the URL. That's what the search engine index. Every search engine, like Google, has its own index. For example, Google has Caffeine, a massive database of URLs. Bing uses its own name to call its database of URLs. Okay, after the search engines do the indexing, okay, now the search engine has all these URLs, and what they do is, okay, we're going to rank these URLs. Now from the top to the bottom, when you write your post and you send that post to the search engines, okay, they are going to index your post, and they are going to rank that URL. You can be in the top, you can be 20th position, 100th position, you don't know. That's the SEO. You are watching this graphic about how the search engines work. First, they do the crawling, they index all the URLs, they're ranking all the URLs, and when the users, for example, you do a query on Google or in Bing, the search engines serve you the results of your query. And start all over again, crawling, index, ranking, and serving results. That's how the search engine works. So, for that, I am going to show you the necessary concepts to understand on-page SEO in this search engine optimization tutorial for beginners. So, what is on-page SEO? On-page SEO is all the work that you can do to optimize your blog or web page in order to get more organic traffic for search engine. You have 100% control of on-page SEO because you own all the elements from the hosting to the code of your web page or blog. Let me tell you this again. You have 100% control of on-page SEO because you own all the elements from the hosting to the code of your web page or blog. It's very important, my friends. You have 100% control of on-page SEO because you own all the elements from the hosting to the code of your web page or blog. So now let me talk to you about all the elements of on-page SEO. Okay, the first element of on-page SEO is the hosting. Choosing the right hosting for your website or blog is very important. Why? Because choosing the right hosting affects the loading time of your website or blog. Why? Because when you start with a website or blog, your website or blog doesn't have much size. It's a light website, it's a light blog. But when you start posting more elements like photos or videos, the size of your website or blog will be bigger, right? So you need a fast loading time, even if your website or blog is getting bigger. So for that, choosing the right hosting is a very important decision. So you know that my recommendation is a cloud hosting, because cloud hosting will give you fast loading times because it's in the cloud. Your hosting will be in the cloud. So for that, you can watch this video about Cloudways, that is my recommendation for you. Cloudways will give you fast loading time because it's a cloud hosting solution. Okay, the next element of on-page SEO is the user experience. Since May 2021, Google is going to be very critical about the user experience that you give to your readers or your users. So, if you have a website, please hire a user experience expert. Hire a UX expert, because the user experience will be a very important part for the ranking in the search engines. And if you have a blog, my recommendation is the schema theme. You can read the post about the schema theme in the link. You will find the link in the description section down below. Please read. I am using that theme for my WordPress blog, and I am very happy with that because also help me with the loading time for my blog and the SEO. Okay, the next element of on-page SEO are the keywords. It's very important to choose the right keywords to rank in search engines. It's very important. If you have a website, you have to choose strategically the keywords for your website. Or if you have a blog, the first thing you must do before writing a new post is to choose the right keyword or keywords for that post. So, I'm not going to be very technically in this video, but let me talk to you about the long tail keywords. It's going to help you to rank high in the search engines. So, what is the long tail keyword strategy? The long tail keyword strategy is focused on keywords or key phrases that are more specific and usually longer than more commonly used keywords. Long tail keywords won't give you a high amount of traffic, but you will have a higher chance to convert each visitor to a customer, as they are more specific. As you can see in the graphic, if you focus on more specific keywords, you will have a higher chance of getting conversion for your webpage or blog, right? So, you see, if you want to rank for the keyword shoes, okay, you will have bigger competitions. You will compete with websites that have 10 years being already on the internet, or blog or more competitive work with high authority domain. But if you choose, for example, red shoes for evening gala, you won't have a big amount of traffic, but the traffic that you will have will be high quality traffic that can convert, right? So, also, if your blog is brand new, my recommendation for you is to focus on long tail keywords, because you need conversions to exist, right? Also, your blog needs to get authority. If your blog ranks high with long tail keywords, then you will get more chances to rank high with more competitive keywords, right? SEO is a long term game. It's a long term game. Okay, the next element is XML sitemap. What you are watching right now is the XML sitemap of my blog, thetechnologysavvy.com. An XML sitemap is a file that lists all the URLs of your website or blog. It acts like a roadmap of your site that lists search engine to all your important pages. For example, this is a basic version of the XML sitemap of my blog. With this XML sitemap, I am telling the search engines that my blog has the organization needed for the robot to crawl my blog. Also, if you have a website without an XML sitemap, you can make one in the webpage xml/sitemaps.com. You will find the link in the description section down below. Another important element of on-page SEO if title and meta description. Titles and meta description are little bit of HTML code that helps search engine understand the context of a web of a page. You need to know that all web pages and blogs are made of HTML code. When someone creates a web page with HTML, that person does it in an order. The first part is the header section. It's in the header that you have to write your title and meta description. For example, you are watching this graphic. In the title of my blog is a technology savvy, and the description, digital marketing and technology blog. Take advantage of digital marketing and the latest tech trends to effectively reach out to your customers. And in Google, look like you are watching the title and the meta description. You have to add your title and your description in the header of your website using HTML code. So, I have a little more description of this on the post on my blog. You will find the link in the description section down below to the post of this video in my blog. So, that were important concepts of on-page SEO. That's not all the important concepts of on-page SEO, but that's all that I show you in a video format. So, I have three more important concepts of on-page SEO, like H1, H2, or the headers in a website or blog, and also about rich snippets. But if you want to know that important concepts, please read the post in my blog. You will find the link in the description section down below, because I can talk about those concepts in details in a writing format. It's very difficult to explain that concepts a detail in a video, in a YouTube video. So please don't get mad at me. You can read those concepts in my blog, the technologysavvy.com. The link is in the description section down below. Now those were on-page SEO. Now off-page SEO. What is off-page SEO? For me, off-page SEO is the public relationship that you do for your blog or website. Why? Because you need to do link building. And link building is when another web page or another blog link to your blog. That was the beginning of search engine optimization. 20 years before this date, everyone was crazy about link building. I need more links to my website to rank high. I need more links to this post on my blog because this post needs more organic traffic. At the beginning, link building was the more important part of SEO, because Larry Page created PageRank, right? So, and PageRank was that code was more about popularity. The more links to a website or a blog, that website or blog will rank high. But the codes evolved, and now link building is just one part of SEO, but it's still important. So, on-page SEO, off-page SEO is all about the PR of your website or blog. You need, beside on-page, beside your website or blog, must be impeccable, so the search engine can crawl your website or blog without any problem. Off-page SEO is also important because you need links to your website or blog. So, how do I get links if my website or blog is brand new? You can get those links just writing in someone else's blog or in someone else's website. You have to write a comment and put a link in that comment to your website or blog. It's that easy. Many blogs is ranking high with just comments. It's the most easy way to start getting links for your website or blog. The moment you start ranking high, someone else will say, hey, we can you put a link to my blog, and then I put a link to my blog. That's the more your website or blog will rank high, the more opportunities you will have to that, to change links with someone else. Right? My recommendation is you have to check if that website or blog has a low spam score. You go to moz.com and put the other website or blog link in the Moz score check, to check the URL check. And if that website or blog have 1 or 2% spam, okay, you can change link with that, or you can comment on that website or blog. That's, my friends, are the most basic concept and the more important concept of search engine optimization. Trust me, search engine optimization is a hard work, because every day you have to check if your SEO strategy is getting results. Every day you have to check your analytics. Every day you have to check if your keywords is ranking on Google or in Bing, on DuckDuckGo. But you have to check. Is search engine optimization is a discipline, right? So I forgot, if your website or blog is pure HTML, you have to do everything manually. But if you have a website or blog on WordPress, good SEO plugins are RankMath and Yoast. RankMath and Yoast are, how can I say? RankMath and Yoast are plugins that will help you with the on-page SEO. But don't think that, okay, I have Yoast or I have RankMath, now I will get a lot of organic traffic. No. Yoast and RankMath helps, but those plugins don't do all the search engine optimization work. It's just a little help. You have to check the on-page of your blog, that Google or Bing can crawl your website, everything in your website. And you have to do the work of link building, of the PR of your website or blog. That's your job. Yoast and RankMath won't do that job, right? So before the end of this video, let me tell you that this video has affiliate links in the description section down below. If you click on that link, you can buy your cloud hosting in Cloudways. I will get a little commission, so I will continue writing on my blog, thetechnologysavvy.com, and I will continue making more of these videos. Please, before you go, don't forget to subscribe and activate the bell, so you will know when I upload the next video. I am Raúl, the Technology Savvy, and I will see you next time. Bye.